my fellow comic book collectors. Today's going to be another one of the price variance battles. We're going to basically battle it out, and I'm going to win. You know how it is. Actually, I think it's pretty much tied.
We're tied at the moment.
Yeah, it's crazy. You know, Mark will win, I'll win, Mark will win. It's kind of annoying. So this is the one. I gotta win this time. So what we're gonna do is it's a cover challenge. We're gonna show covers based on sports. And then on Mark's channel, we're gonna have a second battle where we're gonna do covers based on another theme, a surprise. But you gotta go over to Mark's channel to see. And I bet it's worth your money to go over there to see it. Without further ado, we're gonna get into Mark's first comic, but we have a surprise judge, he's the judge that we always use, and it's the Gray Man. So,
hello.
Gray is always a surprise, right?
Shock, more of a surprise, you know, most people say.
Okay, right, I'm going to start up. I have to say, I found it quite difficult to find comics with sports on them. So you're going to find, I'm afraid I've veined a particular vein of gold for this. And we're starting off, as I mean to go on, with Brave and the Bold, Strange Sports Stories.
Oh, yeah.
And we have got the Gorilla Baseball Team, the Gorilla Wonders, in Brave and the Bold, number 49.
All right, lovely, nice.
Yeah, and we've got a nice gorilla sliding for the base. Is that what they call it?
Is that home plate? It looks like home plate.
Yeah, I think it's home plate. Yeah, because that's with the guy with the gloves, isn't it? That's home base, isn't it?
Yeah, the catcher.
Yeah.
You can tell that you really like baseball there, Mark.
Baseball is just like angry cricket, isn't it, Mark?
Well, it's sort of like, it's like cricket for savages.
Yeah, that's it. Cricket for Neanderthals, which is why an ape is playing it.
When I was working for an American company, I did actually go and watch a baseball bat of my own, baseball match of my own volition.
Match.
It's not called a match.
No, it's called a game.
Okay.
Baseball game.
In Indianapolis. I quite enjoyed it. The only problem was the beer was about 1% alcohol, I think.
Oh, God.
Yes, that's very American.
Yeah, that's no good, is it? Right. Well, am I doing each cover, each points as we go along, isn't it, normally on this one rather than the inequities?
Yeah.
So, yeah, I love that one. That's got great. I love the logo. I love that trade dress, that nice wibbly wobbly.
Oh, yeah, it's quite good, isn't it? Yeah.
Brave and the Bold banner. Can't go wrong with that. You got a date stamp for, you know, UK variants. You know, obviously, sorry, Canada, but I'm kind of on the UK team when it comes to price variants, obviously. And you can't go wrong with a gorilla on a blinking on a DC comic book now, can you? I'm gonna go 9. I'll leave
it at
9.
Thank you very much. That's fair enough. Thank you.
Okay, so I'm gonna show you my first one, and it's kind of a special book. This is a golf cover, and it's Huey, Dewey, and Louie, and they're playing golf, and they're teeing off on on one of the duck's heads, and it's just a great golf cover. It's also their first cover appearance, so that has an extra bonus there. Should get bonus points for that. It's just a cute cover, Disney, you know, at its finest. This is from 1938.
Wow.
So it's like just around the time when Action Comics number one is coming out. It's just, you know, it's got that classic.
Does golf count as a sport?
They're actually thinking of making it an Olympic sport.
Well, I was going to say, it's not in the Olympics, is it?
I thought golf was a good walk interrupted or something, a good walk ruined, isn't it? Is that what they say about golf? Good walk ruined? I think that's the phrase.
It's actually, believe it or not, it's actually the fastest growing sport.
Right, okay.
So, yeah.
It's like fishing, you know.
Yes.
But it is a, you know, there is exercise involved. You do walk, and you every so often you hit something.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So yeah, it might be not be the most action-y sport, but it is a very great sport cover that we got here.
Well, that's a fun little Disney kind of one, isn't it? But it's a bit plain though. That's the thing. There's a lot of yellow there. Not much going on, but I do like the fun of it, the humor of it, and the obviously classic Dutch characters. But I'm gonna go with eight for that one. Go with an eight.
All right. Yeah. So that first round goes to Mark. Okay.
I've got a feeling you might catch up. Right. Next up, I have got a comic called Champion Sports. From DC Comics, Champion Sports number one.
Okay.
So we've got at the top panel, we've got the kid who beat Oakland A's. I've no idea who the Oakland A's are.
No.
In the middle, we've got the little racer with somebody with a sort of homemade cart winning a
box car, is it?
Box car race.
Yeah.
Then we've got some hurdling.
First hurdle. The key to beat
different sports there.
Yeah.
It's called Champion Sports.
Yeah. That's not bad. I normally quite like a split up panel like that with lots of different boxes on it. But I don't know. That's a little bit, I don't know. They're really kind of like exciting. I suppose there's a little bit of excitement on there with the car looking like it's about to crash.
Yeah. And we've got some sort of Hell's Angels coming to attack him at the end.
Really?
Yeah. Can you see the biker there with on his back?
Yeah. Hell's Angels.
Is Hell's Angels a sport? I don't know.
No, it's true.
Well, it's motorbiking. It's a bit like golf. You play it when you get older and you motorbike when you get older, don't you? Sort of to recover your
I quite like it. I was originally going to give it a 7, but I think the Hell's Angels are going to knock it up to 8. I'll give it an 8.
Okay.
Not exactly sport, but it does have an element of interest to the general sport there.
Oh, wow. Okay, so I got to make me work here, Mark. So here's a really great sport. This is gymnastics.
Okay.
And this is also, this is Betty and Me at 55. Or 50, 55. It is the innuendo cover. It's kind of like the, you know, sexual innuendo because she's kind of doing the splits, and you got Archie and Jughead kind of looking over at her doing the splits. So it's just a great gymnastics cover, like, you know.
There's a lot of yellow again, Alan. It's a good job you're not Matilda.
There is more background in that one. I'm not worried about the colour yellow. It's just the fact that it was more yellow. Yeah. Not much else going on. But you got the crowd in the background there, and the stands, the blitz.
There's the crowd. There's the girl on the
someone on the bar.
On the bar, and then there's
what does it actually say? It's even better than the something Pop Tape makes.
Oh yeah, Archie, what do you like? Do you like my split? Yeah, it's even better than the ones Pop Tape makes. Yeah.
Is that to Pop Tate? Is that the guy who runs the soda shop where they have like the ice creams and that?
Yes. Banana split. Right, yeah. Right,
cool. All right, I'm getting it now. I'm understanding it a bit now. I'm going to go. I quite like it. It's quite an unusual sport as well. I never thought I'd see gymnastics being represented in this category. I'm going to go with. I'm going to go with an 8 again though. An 8.
Oh, okay. Oh, interesting. Okay.
Right. I think I might have shown this one before in a previous challenge. I'm really struggling to find sports comics. So this is the Flash Speed Buggy one, and we've got buggy racing.
That's not a sport.
Buggy race. Yeah, they're in a stadium. They're all watching it.
It's true. They're all watching it in a stadium.
I always think of sports as being like, you know, something athletic.
Well, motor racing does count as a sport.
Yeah.
Is it an Olympic sport?
No, but nor is golf.
We did have that one.
Got hoisted by my
I lost on the golf one, so I don't care anymore about it. So.
Right.
Yeah, we've got a lovely background with all the characters in the background. We've got Superman. The full Scooby Doo team.
Ghost.
Dick Dastardly.
Yeah.
Motley. What's the shark called? What's that shark thing called?
Something shark.
Dabajaw?
Dabajaw.
Dabajaw.
Yeah, that's right.
We didn't get
the woman.
How I know that is beyond me. But anyway, yeah, I like the Flash, of course. I don't know.
Is it really a sport? Is the question? Well, yeah.
I think it can. I mean, motorbike racing is a sport. Obviously, humans racing cars isn't a sport, is it? Like, human versus car racing isn't really a sport, but cars racing each other will be a sport, like Formula One and stuff like that.
Well, you know, that's the, you know, they're in a stadium, so
presumably. Yeah, so it's kind of like a sports-like endeavour, but it does raise a point, is it really a proper sport? And I had this trouble. We did sports, I think, on the cover slingers, and Roger showed an off-road motorcycle race. And I was like, that's not a sport, Roger. That can't count as a sport. That's not official. It's got to have rules. It's got to have blinking, a proper body that controls the rules and that. And like, but on that basis, well, I'm going to give that a 7.
Oh, no. I think it's got a 7 last time as well.
Why do you keep on bringing it?
This is the only bleeding sport comic I could find that wasn't Brave and the Bold.
I was veering towards an 8, but Alan's challenge there, I've sort of knocked a point off. Alan does make a point.
1 point good. Character in the audience. I get about 27 then.
So a sport that I actually participate in, and it's an Olympic sport. Actually, I competed in the worlds in this sport myself. Oh, wow. I got a bronze medal, believe it or not.
Really?
It's a judo.
Oh. Won't be nicking any comics off you then.
Yeah, so this is a great, she's actually doing a proper move too. This is drop seo, and it's just it's really classically well done. It's actually, she's doing the move perfectly correct. And she's like throwing her boyfriend, which is really great. So okay. It's just kind of a fun, you know, judo cover.
I don't really know judo, but I like your attention to detail and the fact you've analysed it to see that it is an actual proper, you know, move. And whoever obviously drew
not analyse. He's just looking at the sexy women. That's what he does.
That's a bonus.
Analyzing. That's.
And it even says
judo move.
Judo instructor, I mean, on the guy's shirt. So that's really great. Really captures judo.
What do I do now, teacher? She's already broken his back by the looks of it. I quite like the Slinky Binky logo. I'm going to give that one an 8, I think. I'm going to give another 8 for that one.
Point back, we're equal.
So now we're tied, right?
Yes. Okay, what am I going to show next? Okay, so you will be surprised to know that my next comic is a Brave and the Bold Strange Sports cover. One is the Phantom Prize Fighter. So, as you can see, that guy with the orange hair is taking the jab at the guy in the white boxer shorts, and his hand's gone straight through him.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. The saga of the secret sportsman.
Yeah. I think that's a law of diminishing returns, though, and showing the same comic book twice.
Well, it's not the same comic book.
I've given you points already.
I do know somebody on Cover Slingers who shows 5 comics of the same title.
But I'm not the judge there. I have to put one of the participants and I have to put up the judge in on that show. I'm going to give that one, I'm going to give it an 8.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I'm going to give it an 8, yeah. Go on.
Okay. So... you showed a really great boxing cover, Mark.
Yeah.
But we have to show the best
boxing cover
of all time.
Oh.
Oh, okay.
This is the Superman versus Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali is known as being the greatest sportsman of all time.
Yeah.
You know, this is the classic, you know, boxing cover. You know, that. You know, battle between
it's Neil Adams as well, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's Neil Adams. It's a wraparound cover.
I was going to say that wraparound,
and all the people in the cover are real people.
Like, yeah,
it's got so many cool things. It's got, like, you know, presidents and stuff at the bottom.
Yeah.
You know, it's got some really cool things going on for it. So it's Just it's pretty amazing cover. It's probably one of the best sports covers of all time, I would say.
It's very well drawn, very well laid out. It's amazing, like, crowd scene. The fact that it's, you know, wrap around all the people, you can see who they are. Apparently, I don't own one, but I remember when I went to DC Exhibition, I saw it, like, some rough art of it, or whatever, and I was like, oh man, that's amazing. And I kind of I kind of remembered it, even though I then never owned it. It's like it seemed like it was a classic. Like
it's a classic cover. I saw this in the comic shop, I was like, I gotta get it. You know, it's just like one of those books, you get it when you find it. It's like that kind of book.
If you can afford it, certainly. Well, I'm going to have to give that a 10.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I have to agree.
it's a pretty amazing cover.
Yeah, that is a good cover.
I have to say, if I was judging that, I'd give it a 10. So that's bad news. I think that might be a knockout blow there, Alan.
Possibly.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm afraid, guys... It's a Brave and the Bold, Strange Sports.
Oh,
I know.
Basketball.
This one is the Hot Shot Hoopsters. Can a bantam five of 14-year-olds beat a supersized basketball team?
Ah.
Obviously, this, you know, the little guy here has obviously got some sort of boost from somewhere.
Yeah.
The
Hot Shot Hoopers.
Yeah.
A little scene. It's not a bad little scene.
Not bad. It's hopefully Alan hasn't got another Neil Adam.
Well, you know, the third time, you know, unless, maybe I'm going to give that, I'll give it another 8.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Well, now I need Alan to get 6 now.
Okay. Yeah. So I don't like showing the same title all the time. Like some people that we know. This is another Olympic sport. It, again, it really shows the technique. Actually, I used to watch, whenever the Olympics come out, I actually watch all the sports, even if I don't really like those sports, but actually enjoy this sport. This is figure skating.
Okay.
And that's at the beginning, sport. It is a sport. It's an Olympic sport. At the very beginning, people don't realize this, but when you do figure skating...
Yeah, but synchronized swimming is in the Olympics. I mean, you know.
Okay, well, this is a sport, and it's a very challenging sport. So what they have to do is they have to do their figures. And one of the figures that they have to do in the Olympics is the figure 8. And not only is she doing the figure 8, but she's actually drawing her boyfriend in the figure 8, which is, you know, extra challenging, extra cool. it's a really, like, you know, I like my classic good girl art covers. This is from 1947, and it's just a really, you know, just classic.
Yeah, you might not have shown the same title, but you have shown four covers where most of the background is just plain yellow.
Yeah. Why is she called Tilly the Toiler?
I don't know why she's called, that's just her name. I don't know why she's called Tilly.
What's she toiling at? Has she got a particularly arduous job? Or just weird?
I don't think so. Not really. It is just what it is.
One thing I will say as well, like, figure skating is a sport, but we don't know if she's actually doing sports figure skating or just having a little jolly.
She's doing the figure 8. The figure 8 is like a professional move for figure skating. And it's like when you do...
Where are the other competitors?
Well, no, when you do your figures, you do it by yourself. You have to show that you trace.
She's practicing for sport, you say. She's not doing it for pleasure. She's just practicing for sport. But, okay, that aside, I kind of think that her boyfriend looks like he's got a potato for a nose. I don't know what he looks like inside the
car. Oh, yeah, that's what the character actually looks like. He's kind of a goofy character.
Yeah, her legs look a little, I don't know, strange. It's like, it's not the greatest art, I'd say. No. But he's got some charm, you know, of that sort of period kind of artwork. But I'm going to give that one a 7.
Ooh. Oh no! I think we did we.
If we're scoring it by round, or if we're scoring it by total points. I think if we're scoring it by total points, then you're the winner, Alan.
By 1 point, I believe.
By 1 point, yeah.
Yeah.
That was a close battle.
I'm afraid there was a knockout blow there.
You both got 7. You both got 3 8s. But Mark had a 9 and you had a 10. But Muhammad Ali won it for you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's still the greatest. I haven't got that. He's on my want list. I haven't got that.
And the funny thing is, I have actually some really great sports covers. I just can't find them. That was one of that actually did have
hand. I did have a spare.
We saw that on my cars. I'm sure we saw
that. You're doing cars. All these car covers.
I did show this before. I can't remember what we were doing.
Cars covers.
Oh, car covers. That's right.
Yeah. I was going to say, you were talking about this year, you're going to get some DC bronze. There's loads of bronze horror. There's loads of bronze horror with like sports. There's like boxing against ghouls and stuff like that. Boxing.
Yeah, I've got about half a box of bronze horror, and I thought I've got to have a sports one here. I couldn't find anything.
Oh, no, that's weird.
But you're right. There are some sport ones, but I couldn't.
There's at least three skeleton ice hockey team covers. That I can remember.
They haven't hit my shelves. No, I struggled to find sport. I would have been able, if I'd gone up into the attic, I could have got some of my old British boys comics. They would have had cricket.
I was actually expecting, oh, it's going to be like, you know, yeah. British sports.
I've done two trips into the attic already this week, and that's enough.
Is it really hard to get to your attic or something? What's going on?
I have to climb up a sort of little metal hatch.
Oh, you have one of those like drops down and you got to climb up. Oh. Yeah, I don't blame you then.
Yeah, okay. Right.
So that's part one. I won, so that's good. Can I win part two and then just show my sheer dominance over Mark?
Yeah, it was really you have to go first. It's home advantage.
Yeah, it's home advantage. So it's going to be tough. Actually, even in this one, it was pretty close. So yes, can I win on Mark's channel? So thanks for watching. Go over to Mark's channel to see part two. And thanks again, guys, for coming. And bye for now.
Bye.